Veteran Hollywood actor Donald Sutherland has passed away. His career on stage and screen spanned six decades. The star of highly acclaimed films including Don't Look Now, MASH and The Hunger Games died in Miami after a long illness.
From leading man to character roles, Sutherland's willingness to take on anything made him a favourite with directors. I'm waiting for a report. Donald Sutherland could play any role, starring in drama, comedies, action, thrillers. His range unmatched, renowned for playing complex characters.
I don't play nice or bad or good. I just play the fella. So I can find something in everybody to play.
Born and raised in Canada, he caught the acting bug early.
It defies logic. Who knows? I don't know. When I was 16 years old, I'd never seen a play. I said to my dad that I wanted to be an actor.
Sutherland's first big break was in 1967 with The Dirty Dozen. Starring role in the movie MASH soon followed. A prolific actor who appeared in more than 190 films and TV shows. A starring role in The Hunger Games, introducing him to a new generation of filmgoers. A father of five children, all of whom worked in Hollywood, including his eldest son, Kiefer. The pair starring together in the Western Forsaken.
He's someone that I've wanted to work with for my whole career.
With a body of work spanning 60 years, Sutherland was an indelible screen presence, receiving an honorary Academy Award in 2017.
Thank you for putting my name on this.
Donald Sutherland was 88.
What an absolute icon, and that voice just so distinct as well. Let's go live to US correspondent Tim Lester at Donald Sutherland's star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Tim, he leaves behind an incredible cinematic legacy.
Shervo, he does, and in one sense, a contradiction. Across all of those movies and that six decades of work, not once did he get an Academy Award nomination for a particular movie. Perhaps the Academy realising late in the piece 7 years ago that such a body of work really did need recognising it, and he was given that award in 2017. He became notorious, frankly, for the range of his work, his capacity to pick up that cross-section of roles. My generation knew him as early as those war movies of the late 60s, The Dirty Dozen and the like. Others, of course, came to love him for his role in The Hunger Games. His son, Kiefer, confirming the death today, tweeted, "Never daunted by a role, good, bad or ugly. He loved what he did and did what he loved, and one can never ask for more than that." Both Kiefer and Donald Sutherland star in this run along the Hollywood Walk of Fame. There will be flowers laid there today as they remember a great.
Welcome to you, Brian. He'd been battling a long illness, but was this a shock?
Well, he was 88 years old, as you said, and he wasn't well health-wise, so I don't think this was really a shock to anyone. I think it was really a time of reflection these past few months, knowing that this, you know, was sort of inevitable. And what a life to reflect on, more than 200 shows and films since the early 60s of a man who never won an Academy Award, won two Golden Globes, but never won an Academy Award, and yet every generation has a film or a story that they remember him from.
Yeah, and Kiefer's summary was just so beautiful and so telling of a life well lived in Hollywood. How's the rest of Hollywood reacting to the news?
Well, for those who never worked with him but admired him, the likes of Kim Cattrall or Cary Elwes or Rachel Zegler, all of them are honoring a man that did amazing work but was also a great guy. Ron Howard, who directed him in Backdraft, said one of the most intelligent, interesting, and engrossing film actors of all time. Mm-hmm. And incredible range and creative courage, dedication to serving the story and the audience with supreme excellence. What was interesting about him is he was a character actor. You know, he could do everything from scary to funny. You know, he didn't have that traditional Hollywood good looks. He actually recounted a story once of when he was growing up and he asked his mother if he was good looking. And she said, "No, but he has a great face. No, your face has a lot of character." Well, ouch, I would say initially. Yeah. But in fact, it was that unique character in his face that got him all these amazing roles combined with this amazing performance that he brought to them.
Isn't that interesting? You say, he played so many iconic roles. What will he be most remembered for, do you think?
Oh, my gosh. Well, if you're someone from the younger generation, The Hunger Games will be what you admire him from. But some people will remember him from JFK or Citizen X, for which he was nominated for an Academy Award. And I think that's what's so unique about someone who has such a range in their career. They touch upon everyone, every movie fan's favorites, and they affect them in a different way. You even have Fast Times at Ridgemont High. I mean, Clute, Six Degrees of Separation, The Invasion of the Body Snatchers. It's a long list, and he's touched a lot of people that love movies.
And it could have been such a small role, but totally memorable. The Italian Job jumps out for me as a great role that he played. Thank you so much. Really appreciate your time, and what a reflection that was.
Yeah, thank you.
Our entertainment editor, Peter Ford. Hi, Pete. His body of work spanned more than 50 years, actually.
Yeah, I loved him. Just a beautiful actor and so diverse, as Tim Lester mentioned. You know, he's one of those actors who, to be honest, would do anything. He was old school and believed you're better to be working than not working. So it meant sometimes he ended up in pretty average things, but he was always good in them. And no doubt when his memoir comes out, in just a couple of months' time, actually, called Made Up But Still True, lots of stories will be in that, because he worked with everybody and everybody spoke so highly of him. I mean, mentioning their old school, he was one of those actors who believed turning up on time and knowing your lines and being charming to everybody on the set. And that's not a bad way to be. And you look at that body of work and those movies like the movie of MASH and Clute, Dirty Dozen. My favourite, I think, was Ordinary People. I thought he was stunning in that. It's subtle, you know, subtle at times. But he, very interesting man also, because there was a, this is something that he told to Anderson Cooper, and I thought it was quite interesting, because it shows you how kids can be impacted by what you say to them. And he asked his mum when he was very young once if he was good looking, and this is how it played out.
And I said, "Mother, am I good looking?" And my mother looked at me and went, "Your face has character, Donald." And I went and hid in my room for at least a day.
Did what she say stayed with you?
Not really, just for 65, 66 years. It's not easy, Anderson. It's not easy to know that you're an ugly man in a business like I'm in.
Boy, I don't think he was ugly. He certainly may not be classically good-looking, but he had such a presence because of his height and those piercing eyes and that beautiful, rich voice. And there'd be a lot of people in the industry locally here today who would remember working with him. He came here, I think it was about 15 years ago, to do a TV miniseries version of Salem's Lot. And they filmed it in the studios just down the road from here at Channel 7, the Melbourne Film Studios. And a lot of the exteriors were done at a place called Cresick, just outside Ballarat. And that was a great thrill for all those local actors like Rebecca Gibney and Robert Grubb to work with him. But he was, thankfully, given an Academy Award about 8 years ago. And that was overdue, although the funny thing was he'd never been nominated for an Academy Award. So, you know, there are a lot of great legendary actors who just simply never won or never got nominated. Here you can see some of Salem's Lot filmed right here in Victoria. But in this grab, I'll show you how thrilled he was to get the Academy Award, even though it was an honorary one. Take a look at this.
I was thrilled. It meant everything to me, to my family, to my children, to my wife, everything. It was a very beautiful gesture on the part of the Academy.
So, yeah, I mean, I know the headlines today, Hunger Games star dies and Kiefer Sutherland's dad dies. I mean, they're, you know, that's the clickbait stuff to get younger people clicking on it, but an incredible body of work, and 88 years old, and we take our hats off to him this morning. Yeah.